That was a scary one for Marc Márquez, dropping down the hill, as we said. Look at this, he's fourth gear, around 160 kilometres an hour, as we said, and that rear tyre broke traction, didn't it? Thankfully, it didn't pitch him over the high side, because that would have been a horrible, horrible incident for Marc Márquez. Here he goes then, dropping down through turn number seven. This is where you really start to have the Sachsenring circuit open up a little bit. He just steps out of it. Off the foot peg comes the right leg, and then it's going to grip and pitch him then right again. Thankfully, he was able to gather to a back up. This man has been on the floor far too often so far this season. His crash in that Italian Grand Prix 5 days ago. Marc Márquez is about to dramatically shift the landscape here at the Sachsenring. He drops down through the Wollmann curve, turn number 11. Look at that, he had a fantastic third sector, Márquez. Certainly a good second sector. He's on course here to be back where he feels he belongs in the Sachsenring. P1, the destiny surely here for the 30-year-old Spaniard. He powers the Honda out of the final corner, and Márquez will go into P1, 120.854. And Marc Márquez takes second. He's rapid in that first sector, isn't he, Márquez? Over a tenth clear of the chasing pack. Got some work to do in sector three. Wow, that was a massive moment for Marc Márquez. He just checks that left wrist. That was a big head shake, big tank slapper, wasn't it? On the change of direction, he was about to pitch it into that fifth gear, turn number 11. So I talk us through this.
Here we're going to see it again. As he leans right, the rear lets go. He's on the throttle, but it lets go and he doesn't expect it to. It's like either cold or a tyre that's not working for some reason. You see that big shove with the front. It's because the rear lets go, comes back into line and pushes his weight forward, and then his weight forward pushes the front, you know, goes onto the front tyre.
You don't need to be an international body language expert, do you, Simon, to understand exactly what was going through his mind there. A 93, trying to make it a dozen successive victories here in the Sachsenring. Here he goes and head down, just ahead of him as a reference is his younger brother, former Moto2, Moto3 world champion, Alex Márquez. Oh, baby! Oh, that's horrendous. That is horrendous.
I hope it didn't
catch
his
foot. That's one of the Primo Ducati boys exiting pit lane there. Marc Márquez has lost control going into the first corner. And one of the luckless, was it Joan Zarco or Jorge Martin?
I'm just hoping it didn't catch his foot, you know, as the bike hit his bike, because it just skittled him. Hopefully the foot peg's high enough to miss it, and
it's Zarco
shaken up.
It's Joan Zarco. Look at the damage to Zarco's Ducati side. It almost looks like it's been cut in half. Zarco's coming out the pit lane here. Watch this, and now this is going to be sickening.
He misses his foot.
Oh, he just rips the front end out. Totally rips the front end out of Zarco's Ducati. That was awful. I remember years ago, Simon, that happened with Danilo Petrucci, Pol Espargaró in Aragon. But that looked even worse. Red flag, no surprise here. Poor old Joan Zarco.
Difficult Friday. We start in a good way because it's a circuit that I like it, but then suddenly we arrive on our limit. And then our limit is there, and then I try to improve. We try to work with the setup, but unfortunately we couldn't. And yeah, the moment of the day was that crash with Johan. Well, basically, it was my crash, and yeah, it was a dangerous moment. Lucky for us, we escaped from that. I already see Johan, and he's okay. But you know that if I make a mistake, I say okay, it's my mistake. But this time, okay, I fall down, like many riders in that turn one in the morning, Alex Espargaró, Fabio Quartararo. I mean. When you are pushing for a whole lap is a usual mistake on that corner, but if somebody can avoid that situation, it was Zarco. I mean, when you are going out from the box, you need to check if fast riders are coming, and then if you see this and you want to avoid that situation, you need to stay or to stop in the pit exit. If you are out of the line, okay, you are not disturbing the riders are coming. But if the rider is coming crash, like me, or like in the past, I think it was Pol Espargaró and Petrucci in Aragon, the bike will hit him. So yeah, I mean, lucky. We were. I can say that we were lucky.
Outside of that, after the big moment at the waterfall when the rear nearly came round on you, we saw you give the middle finger on the onboard camera. Just how difficult is it to keep your emotions in check in this current situation?
Yeah, I mean, you know me, I'm trying and I'm pushing and I try to be faster and I try to improve and I try to be smooth and yeah. But then already in that corner, Nakagami had a big crash, massive crash, and I had a few moments and it's a dangerous corner. Dangerous situation. I lose the rear in a very slow lap. So this just your confidence are going out less and less. So yeah, for tomorrow we will try to work and we will try to improve the especially the feeling, not the situation, the feeling.
For more MotoGP action, don't forget to like and subscribe. See you at the races.